In the beginning, the Supreme God Amma, He who rests upon nothing, the intelligent consciousness behind all of creation, and the awareness within all beings, created the universe within a tiny grain called Po. This grain was placed like a black hole in the center of the universe. This original germ of life is symbolized by the smallest cultivated seed, commonly known as Funyo, and also called by the Dogon people of Mali, West Africa, by the name Kizi Izi, meaning the little thing. Amma spoke seven words into this seed, and then, quickened by an internal vibration, this seed burst forth, moving along a spiral helix path, emerging to reach the uttermost confines of the universe. When the Po burst forth, eight new seeds were created. These eight seeds were then placed in Amma's egg in the solar system of Sirius. The solar system of Sirius is a binary star constellation located only 8 light years from Earth, and is the brightest star in the night sky from Earth. The larger star of the Sirius binary solar system is called Sirius A, or Sigitolo, being the younger of the two stars. The smaller star, called Sirius B, or Potolo, is the oldest of the two stars, and is the star of the deep beginning, and the first of all stars. Potolo, or Sirius B, is the reservoir source of renewing life force for this realm of creation. Potolo is very dense, and is made from a metal which the Dogon people call Sagala, which is the heaviest element in the universe. The center of the Vesica Pisces of the Sirius binary star orbit is called Emayatolo, which is the mother guardian of feminine essence. With the eight seeds placed in Amma's egg in Sirius, Amma intended to create the first eight amphibious celestial beings called the Nomo, four males and four females. Amma ordained that these beings should be living manifestations of the fundamental universal principle of complementarity or twinness. The males and females were brothers and sisters, yet husbands and wives. This principle manifests itself as the wholeness which is created when female and male pairs join in all things. Such pairing establishes equilibrium, cooperation, balance, and harmony. Amma therefore equipped each being at birth with twin souls, both female and male. However, one of the male twins named Ogo, did not wait for the full gestation period to be born. Ogo, who was self-willed, burst forth from Amma's egg, and brought himself into being. Ogo then took fragments of the placenta from inside of Amma's egg, to create his own solar systems and planets. The sun star that Ogo created is called Ne, and it is the sun star which the planet Earth orbits. The planet Earth is the world created by Ogo. The solar system of Earth is known as Ogo's placenta. Since Ogo did not wait for his full gestation period, and created a world with only a fraction of his placenta, all of the beings inhabiting Ogo's world of Earth, were single-souled incomplete beings like himself. Realizing that his creations were incomplete and imperfect, Ogo returned to Amma seeking his complementary female twin. However, because Ogo's actions greatly disrupted the order of Amma's creation, Amma gave Ogo's female twin over to the other Nomo who remained in Amma's egg to re-establish order. To purify creation and the world from Ogo's transgression, Amma had to sacrifice a pair of the completed and perfected Nomo twins named Nomo Semi. In one swift cut, Amma sacrificed Nomo Semi, and the energy of the sacrificed Nomo was used to consecrate the Sirius solar system and the Earth solar system created by Ogo. Amma's goal was to purify his creation from the transgressions of Ogo, and it required him taking a pure and perfected being, Nomo Semi, and sacrificing it. Amma intended for the spirit of Nomo Semi to heal Ogo's torn placenta and become one with the impure earth Ogo created. When the sacrificed Nomo Semi's energy was sprinkled upon the earth, It caused Nomo Semi to be resurrected as the 8 original ancestors of humanity, 4 males and 4 females, who now had separate forms, and were paired in 4 couples united in the image of the original 8 Nomo. Ogo's self-willed actions threw off the universal balance Amma had intended. Ogo's act of theft and creating with his own placenta was seen as an incestuous act, because the placenta is likened to the mother, so creating with his own placenta was like Ogo raping his mother. Ogo was then seen by Amma and the other Nomos as a disruptor, and one who causes chaos and war. Amma ordered one of the other Nomo named Tai Tianyi to punish Ogo for his misdeeds. Nomo Tai Tianyi smashed Ogo's genitalia, making him infertile, and Ogo fled from Sirius down to Earth. Once on Earth, Amma wanted to bind Ogo to Earth so that he could not disrupt celestial order anymore. Amma transformed Ogo into a pale fox named Yaogo, or Yurugu, who has been engaged in a perpetual and fruitless search for his female counterpart and twin. Once on Earth, the pale fox Yurugu continued his disruptive and chaotic behaviors. Seeing this, Amma decided to send to Earth the Nomo of the other half of the egg, creators of the sky and the stars. Assuming the guise of blacksmiths, they came down to Earth on a gigantic arch. At the center of the arch stood the Nomo of the sky, and at the 4 cardinal points were the 4 other Nomos, avatars of the ancestors of man. The arch constituted a new, an undefiled Earth, which coincided with the appearance of light in the universe. The Nomos remained in the waters of Earth as teachers and monitors of humanity. The Nomos are the origin of the Mesopotamian story of Enki, the reptilian blacksmith whose daughter was named Namu. The Nomos are the origin of the story of the Assyrian and Babylonian fish god named Dagon, Adipa, and Owens. The Nomos are the origin of the Ogdoad reptilian deities in ancient Egypt. The Nomos are the origin of stories of mermaids, mermen, and merfolk in ancient folklore, and the Nomos are the origin of the Nubian and Sudanese stories of the Dogar beings who live underwater in the Nile River and impregnate women while they are swimming. The Nomos are the river angels, and the Dagon people of Mali commemorate them in their religious tradition called the Sigguti, which occurs every 60 years in accordance with the cycle of the Sirius star.